Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a quiz using Microsoft Forms. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So here I am on office.com. And I can see all the free apps on office.com over here. And if I click this apps button, I can go to Microsoft Forms by clicking this button right here. And once I'm in Forms, I can go up to new quiz. And a new quiz is going to load. So I'm going to call this one Chemistry Test 1. And so let's do a basic chemistry quiz for today with several different kinds of answers. So for our first one, let's go down here to add new, and we'll go to choice. And here we will ask, what is the eighth element of the periodic table? And down here we can put some options. So let's put hydrogen, helium, and down here we can add another option, oxygen, and let's add a fourth one, carbon. And so for each one of these answers, let's say that there is only one correct answer. So the way that we indicate that is by checking this check mark right here, and it will turn green. The rest will have an icon that has an X next to it. Now, if you would like to give some immediate feedback to the people who are taking your quizzes, if I go up here to hydrogen, I can click here where it says notes, and I can say the correct answer is oxygen. And if I copy that, I can also put that same note for the other three answers. I can also delete an option by going here to this delete icon. And then down here, I can assign a number of points. So let's say this is worth 10 points on my quiz. And over here, I'm going to mark this as required because I'm not going to allow my students to skip any questions on this quiz. I can also have multiple answers, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. So next I'm going to go to add new, and let's do one more choice. And this time I'll show you one that has multiple answers. So for this one, let's do which elements are on the first line of the periodic table. So down here, let's do boron, helium, add another option, iron, and hydrogen. And this time we can go to multiple answers and turn that on. And instead of having circles, we now have squares. So I'm going to select helium and hydrogen as the correct answers. And let's say this is worth 10 points as well and also required. So next I can go to add new, and I can go to a text answer, and I can say how many elements are found on the periodic table. And I can also add an answer down here. And let's put the answer 118, and then click add. And let's make that worth 10 points as well. So my final question, let's go to add new, and let's enter a date type question. So let's just type, when did Marie Curie die? And this type of question will let the user put in a date right here. And then finally, if you're curious, you can hit add new and put in a rating and say, what do you think of this class so far? And I would say make this worth 0 points. So by default, your students can rank your class up to 5 stars, but you really have a range in here where you can go anywhere from 2 all the way down to 10. And instead of using a star, you could also just use a number symbol. But I'm going to keep it 5 stars, just like it was by default. Okay, a couple other things we can do is reorder your questions. Say I want to move this question up to number 4, then the Marie Curie question moves to number 5, but this is a good last question for the quiz, so I'm just going to move that back down with the down arrow right here. I can also copy a question and have a duplicate question right here. And so if I wanted to do, what do you think of the teacher, and have that be another rating type question, I could leave that on there as well. Another thing I can do to my quiz is go up here to theme, and I can add a theme to my quiz. So let's scroll down here And let's just add the beakers right here since it's a chemistry test. And then let's preview and see what it looks like. So if I hit the preview button up here, I can now see what my quiz is going to look like when it's being sent out to my students. This is what it will look like on a computer screen. And this is what it will look like on a mobile screen. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. I can also go over here to the send button and I can copy this link and send this to all my students, or I can come down here and click the email button to send an automatic email to all of my students. I can click this button here to generate a QR code that I can download. I can embed this on a website by clicking on this button, or I can share this with social media with either Facebook or Twitter right here. So for now, let's go back to link and copy the link and go into a new window and let's take our quiz. And I'm just going to answer the first question for every single one of these. When did Marie Curie die? Let's just pick a date. I don't like this class and I don't like my teacher, so now I'm going to submit this. Now, one thing I want to show you here. Your students can hit view results and they can see how they did on their quiz. Now this can be good or bad. If you have control over when your students are going to take the quiz and you're going to be in class and they don't have access to another computer, then by all means allow them to do this. But if you don't want that option of where they can view these results, you can close out of here and go back to your quiz options right here on these three dots. And if I go down to settings, I can just toggle that off and the students won't be able to see the responses. I also have a few other options down here. I can select a start date and an end date for the quiz so that the quiz will only be accessible for a certain date range. I can also shuffle my questions so that different students get the questions in a different order. I can get emails every time someone responds and takes my quiz, and I can also create a customized thank you message for when the students are done with the quiz. Also, if I go over here to responses, I have a couple of different options in here. I can see some general metrics on the quizzes that have been taken. I can open these responses in Excel and do some further analysis on each one of my questions. I can go over here to review answers, and I can also see how different respondents answered. And if I go back, I can also post the scores of all the quizzes after I have graded them so everyone can see how they did. And to grade the quizzes, I can go over here to review answers and I can see that this has been auto graded, but I do need to go down here and I need to review this question right here. So I can click right here and enter feedback and say, sorry, this is incorrect. And I can give 0 points here. And same for here, I'll just have to put a zero here and a zero here because they're not worth anything anyway. I can also see the quiz responses by question. But for now, I only have one response. So let's say someone else takes the quiz. And this person does really well on the quiz. So now when I go to review answers, I can see that another user has taken a quiz by clicking this arrow right here. And if I go to questions, I can see how many students have responded to question one and what their scores were. And then I can click this arrow and go through each one of the questions and see how people did. But remember, I can also download these to Excel. So hopefully this gives you a good introduction to how you can create a quiz inside of Microsoft Forms. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.